Yeah, but it's a real respect. How about going to Parliament, which was now the most audacious thing?
the day of opening, 10th August, at 11 o'clock, Parliament convenes. So it takes about half an hour from my house. So exactly at 10:30, I came out. My car was in the porch. Mm-hmm. So it's just 1 second you can be seen. I went and sat in. Fine. In my kurta pajama.
But now you were looking like Swami, not
yes,
like
yes, yes. No, Sardarji.
Even then, the cops outside your house didn't.
Even when I came from America, I looked like myself.
Okay.
Because I gave up the Sardarji dress after November 75.
Okay. So you got into the car.
Yes.
And you drove to Parliament.
Parliament. And I told my wife, you get down outside the gate. And those days, you see, you could park next to the door.
Yeah.
There was no security. So I said, if I make it, then go to Birla Mandir parking lot. Hmm. There I would have put the key under the mat. And you can drive the car back. And if the car is missing, then it means I've been arrested.
Okay.
So she agreed to do that. So I went. And of course, I carried with me a Western clothing, shirt, pant, Gandhi topi. Hmm. To look like a youth Congress worker later on. So I went in my normal dress. The watch and ward staff saw me and asked
at
me.
At Parliament?
Yeah, the gate. They recognized me naturally, otherwise they let me in. They asked me, Swami Sahib, aap chut gaye. That is, have you been let off? Huh. I said, nowadays anybody can be let off by signing 20-point program. I wasn't telling any lies, but I was bluffing him.
Yeah.
Oh, he said, kya jail mein rehkar kya karna hai? What is the point in staying in jail? But the policeman there, sub-inspector, he started telephoning because the warrant I knew in advance information, which was supplied to me by my friends, was always in the police station. So he cannot arrest me without a warrant. So he was phoning up to check whether there is a warrant or not. Mm. But I knew that he will not get the SHO because that day, the same time, Sanjay Gandhi was addressing in the Pragati Maidan the Youth Congress rally on Quit India movement. Hmm. So all these Chamchagiris types would have gone there. Hmm. So those days you didn't have mobile phones or communication. That. So this guy was going on phoning. Meantime I went in, I saw Inderjit Gupta communist. He said, hey, you have come? I said, yeah, what's the point staying there? So he said, come on with me. So he picked my hand and he took me inside. Opposition was boycotted, so the entire bench of the opposition was empty. I sat down. Just the timing was perfect that as I went and sat down, he was the president, vice president,
BD Jetty,
was reading the last name on the obituary list.
Right.
So I got up, sir. I said, I have a point of order in between the two sessions. Democracy has also died. You should have included that also. So it's all there in the records now. So, and he said, no, there's no point of order. So I said, in that case, I'm walking out. And then he said, everyone will stand at 2 minute silence. Now, all these people are stunned seeing me because they thought I was abroad.
Yeah.
And I don't know what I had come to do. In fact, Om Mehta told me, I thought you were going to throw a grenade or
there's
something.
There's a story that Om Mehta hid under
Yeah, he went like that.
He was actually the home minister of India. And he slunk into a state of fear he would throw a bomb or something.
Hand grenade. Yeah. So, by the time 2 minutes were over, I was already out. The watch and watch staff became relaxed. He went